Welcome back to Let's Play Fallout 2. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We are here in Modoc, which I can't help but think is named after a Marvel Comics villain who fought, among others, was he a predominantly Captain America foe? Just guess seeing him battle the Hulk as well. Very strange looking guy, Modoc, if you can even call him that. Basically, his head was replaced with some kind of monitor which shows an image of his face, which is all distorted up. That was weird. I think he genetically changed himself or something like that, but I don't know. We've got some kind of nondescript building, or some kind of outhouse there with a goodie in it. It's not very often we get highlightable things show up on the map. But it works because you hit shift and that's the same to run, so. I start running around. Okay, this guy's sitting here with a rifle. A very active old man. The name's Grisham. Welcome to my slaughterhouse. You're dropping off or picking up? I guess picking up. I'm interested in buying some traveling provisions.
Ah, of course, of course. Let's see. For traveling, I recommend our world-famous dried Brahmin strips. Won't spoil on the road and it's tasty, too. Only $10 a package. You interested?
Can I ask you a few more questions? I don't really need Brahmin strips.
What can I do for you now?
Can you tell me a little bit about the slaughterhouse?
Not much to tell. I run the slaughterhouse in Modoc. You want something slaughtered, you bring it to me. I'll kill it for you and make it into some of the best jerky you've ever tasted.
What about the hides and other parts of the animal?
You are quick, aren't you? Well, if you ask, you can retrieve any part of the animal you want. Balthus will usually buy the hides and Rose will buy whatever scraps you don't want. She uses it to make soup and feed her dogs.
Ask you a few more questions. I see the drought hasn't affected your business yet.
Actually, it's kind of helped my business. Nobody has been able to grow sufficient food for their Brahmins, so they're severely cutting their herds, or culling their herds. But that's just a temporary thing. You have to look at the big picture. With the decline in the Brahmin population, my business can only suffer.
Alright. Bye.
Wait, you look to be a capable traveler. I don't suppose you'd be interested in making some money.
That depends. How much? What do I have to do? And most importantly, how much?
Smart as a whip. You remind me of myself when I was young. Simple. Some wild dogs have been coming down out of the hills looking for food. I think they find Brahmin easy prey and have been attacking my herds nightly. Wipe out their pack and I'll give you $1,000.
You're holding something back, you old coot. What's the catch? $1,000.
Perceptive as well as smart. I knew I wouldn't be able to pull anything on you. The catch is that for every Brahmin you let get killed, I charge you $100. I pay well for success and I also charge for failure. That's the risk you take working for me.
Sure.
Great. Head out to the pastures at night and kill the pack of wild dogs that are attacking my Brahmin. Come back here when you finish the job.
Oh, we're here now. Okay. Attack! Attack them! Wait. I hope they help me out. I guess I can heal the Brahmin, couldn't I? My friends are not helping. Because they're not attacking me, I should have adjusted the AI. Sulik just took some jet. I didn't want him to do that. OK, Okay, good. Damn it. Are they gonna actually shoot anything? When do I get to go? Alright. 20 out of 35 hit points. That's a tree. Okay. Now they should shoot what I shoot, I think. Or what attacks me, I'm not even sure. Die, please. Seriously, critically hit, but for only 1 point. Come on, guys, we want all this money. Am I gonna hit the Brahmin? Good. I'm trying to anticipate where they're running to. Oh, you killed the Brahmin, you damn it. Ah, they killed another one. Down to 800. I wish my friends were helping. I missed, damn it. Myron's out of ammo. Wild dog was hit. We be smelling the fear on you, man. Okay, good. Yes, hit our friends, not... Ah, damn it. Down to 700. Ah. Damn you! These are both dead, but they're gonna go after other things. I'm missing at 92%. Nice. Grumpy Bone made you miss. The lizard bro that we ate before wants out now. What? What? Lizard bro? Now here I'll probably get this thing. I hit the Brahmin instead! God damn it! What are we down to, 600 now? We've got 1, 2, 3, 4... I killed one over here. Before. 5. Damn, this sucks. How's this one doing? He's still got a lot of hit points. They're focused on him. The only one directly attacking a Brahmin at this point is this one. So, I wanna... get over to him. Yes, revenge! We like the insides just the way they are, man. Suluk doing? He's gonna hit a lot. These aren't. I am. Where? Can I move? 3. Don't hit the Brahmin! God damn it. Nice. I don't know where to get more of Myron's ammo from. Yeah, that's right. Who's the badass now? 25 points. 25. 7. Got 2 left. I think the 2 wolves left. I thought he didn't have any more ammo for the thing, the pipe rifle. Looks like I killed them all. Moo. Oh well. Where are we? Brahmin pastures. I guess I just move, you know, off of here. No goodies around here. Keep the fire burning. Alright, we're done then. Well, that was unexpected. I thought we were just gonna get to it whenever we got to it, and ba-dum. All of a sudden, time passed and we were here. Alright. Slaughterhouse. Sorry, you're gonna charge me. Oh, this is the slaughterhouse itself. Yeah, let's wait around. So we can see better. Waiting till morning again. This barrel contains burning paper and other flaming refuse. Brahmin meat. Instead of going out the door, I'm okay. That's comical. Before I go back in, let's go see what this thing is. It's like some ammo. Suluk is overloaded. Why is Suluk overloaded all of a sudden? Not interested in the tin wall. It's a book. Guns and bullets, we can sell that.
What you be needing?
You're overloaded, huh?
Spirits be willing to talk. What you want?
What do they tell you about this place?
That which is a door does not always lead to anywhere. That which is not a door does.
A door doesn't always lead to anywhere. But a door does lead anywhere. A not door leads anywhere. Okay, whatever. I was gonna trade with you. I got distracted. I'm not interested in the desert scrub.
What you be need?
Wow, those are like 5 pounds each or something like that. I can't even carry one of them. Are you kidding? He can only carry 50? Since when? No. They haven't been telling me he's overloaded. All of a sudden he's overloaded. Maybe he's tired? I don't know. We just rested, though. And I have... Wait. I have 114 out of 175, and I can't carry one of those water chips?
What you be needing?
Too much to carry. How much is that? Groups of five to a box? I can take them. Why does it tell me? They're 2 pounds each. I can take those.
What you be needing?
So can only carry 50 pounds. But he's currently carrying 103. I can't help but think this is bugged at this point. See, he can carry 96 out of 150. Is something... Is he just damaged? He must be damaged. His foot must hurt or something. Must be. Doctor's bag. I'm not good at this though. I failed to do any healing.
What you be need?
We want women in the chicken shit outfit. Dogs. Yeah, he must have gotten damaged. So it doesn't say that he's hurt. Thank you. Guess I should improve doctor a few times. Would I select Vic and then talk to him? What is this? I fail. One more time. I fail. All right.
What you be needing?
Yeah, he must be hurt somehow. Wish I could find out. So new one. It does nothing. I can't heal people with that. I can only heal myself. Three? I had three. So I'll make sure I didn't waste it.
What you be needing?
Did that fix anything? No. He's got like his arm or his foot is hurt or something like that. I think eventually, after enough rests, we'll fix that. It's just crazy how I couldn't hold those water chips. That was stupid. Is this where? Is this the guy we were talking to? Sent us on this quest? Wait, how do we even get in here? I'm not sure this is it. Oh, the door is actually open. Grisham. I knew you'd be able to handle it. Now, let's see now, I owe you $1,000 for completing the job. Of course, 5 Brahmin got killed due to your carelessness. Yeah, rub it in. At 100 Brahmin, your reward is 500. Don't even bother to lie about the number of Brahmin killed. I had one of my boys follow you out and watch from a distance. Why didn't you have them help? Thanks, Pops. Pleasure doing business with you. Alright, let's talk to the rest of these people in here. Well, that's Sulik. Anybody in here? I can actually move out of there. Nice. Handsome young man. Hi, my name is Davin. I helped my father run the slaughterhouse in Modoc. At which point we ask him what he does at the slaughterhouse. Well, I supervise and take care of stuff. I'm the owner's son, after all. I'm going to inherit this place when my dad kicks off. That's a hell of a way to put it. Can I ask you a few more questions? Sure, I'm not busy. Ask away. Have I heard rumors? Tell me about your dad. Dad runs a slaughterhouse. He's okay as far as fathers go. Word of advice, if you do any business with him, there's usually more to his business deals than he lets on. Yeah, we found that out. Can I ask you a few more questions? Okay. This is a little, I guess, what that entails. I hear rumors about you and the Brahmin. It's a lie. I only go out to the barn at night to, make sure everything is locked up. You know, with all the wild animals around and all. Ask you a few more questions. Yeah, we're not gonna get more comfortable. Come back and see me if you wanna talk again. Uh-huh. Would she more get comfortable too? Oh my, a very shapely and seductive looking woman. Why, hello there, stranger. I'm Miria. What do you do around here? Who, me? I do odd jobs here and there. Surely nothing worth talking about. She flutters her eyes at you. What? I get into this after. If I weren't so bored, I'd say no, so ask away. The questions. What can you tell me about the slaughterhouse? Nothing to tell. My family runs the slaughterhouse. People from all around bring their Brahmin here for slaughter. After they are slaughtered and the meat treated, it is sold to traders, who in turn sell it to merchants in various towns. All very boring, if you ask me. Heard any good rumors? Have you come to the right place? This town is so boring, there's nothing else to do but gossip, and she keeps talking for a while, and sometime later you're able to get a word in. Tell me about Davin. He's family. I don't spread rumors about my own family. What else do you want to know? You mentioned something about Rose? Ah, Rose, the proprietor of Rose's Bed and Breakfast. Now, you didn't hear it from me, but have you ever wondered why her coop is so well protected? She says it's to protect her chickens from predators, but if you look closely, it looks as if she's trying to keep something in rather than out. Plus, whoever heard of chickens laying 12-pound eggs? What's this about a mutated Brahmin? It's really strange, but I hear some ranchers say that every once in a while a Brahmin will give birth to a calf with only one head. Talk about weird. I really would like to know more about you. I'm really touched. Nobody ever tries to get to know me better. All they want is sex, sex, sex. I get so bored of having wild sex all the time. I'm so glad you're not like the others. I thought you was special for a moment. Yeah, let's pour on the charm, why not? Well, I've never known anyone as interesting as you are. She blushes. Stop, you're embarrassing me. You were just the sweetest thing. Why don't you come over here and sit by me? Why not? I thought you'd never ask. Why don't we get a little more comfortable? How disappointing. You're just like everyone else, aren't you? No, I don't think so. I'm tired of this conversation. Goodbye. Aw. I could have said a lot worse than that. I'm so pleased you came back. What can I do for you now? I think this is going too far. Can't we just talk? I can't take this anymore. You're perfect. She rips off her clothes, your clothes, and then your world will never be the same again. Okay. Well, that's an interesting way of coming about it. What's going on in here? Daddy. Uh-oh. Holy shit, I knew Miria was different, but there's only one way to make this right. Are we gonna have a fight now? He's gonna shoot me? There's only one way to make it right? I can't say I'm not just a little turned on by this, but I can't have her living in this house now that I've seen it. You two are gonna have to get hitched and leave. What? Don't I get a say in this? What? Are you kidding? Dearly beloved, we are gathered here. Oh my God.